Talk about Pure Land Buddhism. What is the Pure Land Buddhism? Basically, it's when we believe in the Amitabha Sutra. It says your passing hours, if you chant Amitabha Buddha's name, he will take us to his Pure Land where there's no more reincarnation and you are bound to become a Buddha. There are three parts to this Pure Land Buddhism. The first is faith, the second is vow, and the third is practice. So if you have faith, vow, and practice, you'll definitely go to the Western Pure Land. Let's talk about the three pillars of Pure Land Buddhism. First, you have to have faith. This faith is believing in the six truths. This is not just the religious faith. This is the faith about some very important truth about the universe. First, you have to have faith in oneself. Oneself, we mean you have faith in that you have the Buddha nature, so you are the same as all the Buddha that already reached Buddhahood. There is a person, one day he passed by this farm, and then he noticed in this farm, there's all the chicken, there's actually one eagle. But the eagle, he behaved just like a chicken. You know, he's raised and here and then feel like he's a chicken. So this person asked the farmer, can I buy this eagle? I want this eagle to fly. He bought the eagle and he brought the eagle up to the mountain and say to the eagle, you are an eagle, you are not a chicken, so please fly. And every time he tried to make him fly, he just keep falling because he thinks he's a chicken. Then the person brought the eagle higher up in the mountain and say to this eagle, you are an eagle, you should fly. But he keep falling. Lastly, he brought him to the top of the mountain and say to the eagle, you are an eagle, you should fly. And finally, he opened up his wings and start flying. So are we a chicken or are we an eagle? We are actually all born as eagle because we are all Buddha. We all have the Buddha nature just like all Buddhas. So we are the same as Buddha. It's just that we haven't believed and faith in our own nature. First, believe that you have the Buddha nature. Second is to believe in others. This is a pair, this is a pair, this is a pair. So believe in your own power and your own strength as a Buddha, and also believe that outside of you, there is outside forces. Buddhas, they actually exist. There's really an Amitabha Buddha. He actually really created the Pure Land for us to go to because he knows that we cannot reach Buddhahood by our own strength. We need someone's help. So he created the perfect school. Over there, you're not likely to have any defilements because the environment is perfect. You're in this perfect place to cultivate into Buddhahood. So believe that Buddha is always with you. If you chant his name, he will come help you. If you really believe in Buddha, if you are taking a test, if you chant his name, you should feel very well, at peace. You shouldn't be nervous anymore. Or if there's earthquake or something happened, if you really believe in the Buddha, you chant his name, you should not be afraid anymore. So that is true belief. Have faith in the Buddha's power. The third is to believe in the causes. All the good deeds is a cause and you will have good effect. Cause and effects go together. So what's the cause? If you chant the Buddha's name, that is a cause. So no matter when or where you chant the Buddha's name, that is a good cause. The good cause will give you effect. The effect is going to the Pure Land and reach Buddhahood. Okay, so you gotta believe, have faith in the cause and the effect. That is for real. In the Lotus Sutra, when Shakyamuni Buddha was around, 2,600 years ago in India, one time there was an old man. He went to the Buddha's place, but Buddha was not there that day. So he asked the disciple, can I become a monk? Then all the disciples, they sat and started meditating, tried to see the old man's past, to see if he has any affinity with Buddha. They looked and looked. This old man, he has no affinity with Buddha in 80,000 kalpas. You know, that's a long, 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 long time. So they say to the old man, I'm sorry, you shouldn't try to be a monk because it's pointless. You have no affinity with Buddha through your past lifetime, so there's no point for you to become a monk. So the old man started crying because like, oh, I really want to be a monk. And Shakyamuni Buddha came back and he asked the old man, why are you crying? He says, oh, because your disciples, they tell me I cannot be a monk because I have no affinity with Buddha. Buddha said to his disciple, you guys are wrong. Before 80,000 kalpas ago, this person, he was a lumberjack. One time, he went to the mountains and there was a big tiger. The big tiger was chasing him, so he was really, really afraid. He went up to the tree and he said, homage to Buddha. So with that one homage to Buddha, this lifetime, he can be a monk. And he will reach Buddhahood because of that one chant. Okay. Believe that any affinity we build by chanting Buddha's name is a big miraculous cause that will give you miraculous results of becoming a Buddha and going to the Pure Land. The fifth and the sixth, believe in the inner truth and the phenomena. The inner truth creates the physical reality. Every physical reality is created by our own mind. So for example, there was this person, his whole life he's very, very sincere in his chanting, and one day he got sick. One day he was chanting and he told his family member, hey, our living room over there, it's the Western Pure Land. Amitabha is there on his lotus flower, and you know our grandchild that passed away a while ago, he is also there next to Buddha, next to the water, playing and bowing to Buddha. So who created this? Actually, his pure mind created the Pure Land. He is actually here, but he's actually already in the Pure Land. So we say a pure mind creates the Pure Land. If our mind is pure right now, we are already at the Pure Land. So all physical locations are created by our heart. So have a peaceful and virtuous and compassionate heart, then we create a wonderful life and a physical existence. So believe in the six things. After you have strong belief, you should have vows. What's vow? Vow means something you really want. In this lifetime, some people want to be a doctor, some people want to be a singer, some people want to be an artist, some people want to be a president. Now that's their life goal. Okay, life goal. But what is our life goal? What is your life goal? What do you want to be? Our life goal is to reach Buddhahood, to become a Buddha. That's our goal. With this vow, there's two parts to it. First, you gotta detach from the mundane world. In order to reach Buddhahood, first you have to let go of your attachment to the current world. Doesn't mean you should hate your life right now. It just means you should let go of your ego and your selfishness. Attaching to this world means attaching to all your belongings right now. If you're always attached to this selfish life, you'll never reach Buddhahood. You have to detach yourself from all the worldly desires. By being selfish and have a lot of ego and have worldly desire, we'll never reach Buddhahood. So realize that, you know, as the first vow. And the second part is seeking the Pure Land. You wanna be detached from all your ego and defilements, and you want to seek the Pure Land. That symbolizes you want to seek Buddhahood. You want to become enlightened. You want to have the perfect, complete wisdom. You want to be the same as Buddha that can help all sentient beings get out of the six realms of reincarnation. That is a very heroic mission. We all should be on purpose and have a heroic mission for ourselves. That this lifetime, I'm reaching toward my Buddhahood. Because I have the Buddha nature, and if I work hard at it, cultivate, chant Buddha's name, and reaching for the Pure Land, I can do it. Okay, so the vow is something that you really want for yourself. And that is what we want to be good at. So after you have faith and you have vow, you will do it. You will practice. The practice part is actually the easy part. Faith and the vow is actually the hard part. The practice is actually easy. All you have to do is reciting Amitabha's name single-mindedly. This practice is actually very easy. All you have to do is say his name, Amitabha, Amitabha, Amitabha. Why do we do that? His name means I should be awakened. I want to be enlightened. Every time you chant his name, you should say to yourself, I want to reach Buddhahood. So whenever if you're angry and you chant Amitabha, it should remind you, I should stop being angry. It's not right. A Buddha is not angry. I want to be enlightened. I should be awakened. So by chanting his name constantly and single-mindedly, that means we're always mindful of our actions and our words. We want to be just like Buddha. Just like you think about your mom. You don't have to say, mom, 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 mom. You don't have to chant her name all the time. But you remember what your mom teaches you. You shouldn't fight with other people. You should be kind to others. You always remember your mom's teaching. Just like you always remember Buddha's teaching. That is called chanting his name. If you do that all the time, then definitely Amitabha Buddha will come get you. At the end of your life, you will have your own lotus flower and he will bring you to the Western Pure Land. You can cultivate into Buddhahood. By knowing the faith and vow and practice and actually do it in this lifetime, you already won the lottery because you are all set. You're guaranteed into Buddhahood. Okay, once you get there, you're guaranteed. So nothing is better than this. This is the secret of life. If you really understood, really take into heart, you will change your whole life and you'll definitely reach Buddhahood. Not only this lifetime, you will have Buddha's blessing and you will have a great life. After this lifetime, you're gonna go to Pure Land and become a Buddha. So nothing is more happier than this. Okay, so that's the class for today. Thank you for listening. Amitabha.